morning, and welcome back to the WFTDA International Playoffs, live from Winston-Salem, North Carolina, brought to you by Greensboro Roller Derby and the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. I am Julia Sleezer.
I'm October Revolution.
And we are going to watch Rainy City Roller Derby taking on Helsinki Roller Derby this morning. Of course, Rainy City is from Manchester, England, and they are coming into the tournament as seed number 3 and are currently ranked at number 10 in the WFTDA. And Helsinki is from Helsinki, Finland. They will be coming in as the seed number 6 and ranked 16 in the WFTDA. So let's look at some rosters. Tober, ready to do Helsinki?
Yes, I'm going to read Helsinki Roller Derby All-Stars. Number 112, Fuchs. Number 156, Mia. Number 22, Malu. Number 24, Kayala. Number 28, Nina Irwes. Number 39, Maya Rine. Number 42, Noki. Number 51, Alu. Number 608, Sarah Ekholm, who's the captain. Number 613, Jamina Lugora. Number 77, Rutsilainen. Number 85, Latikainen. Number 88, Varpu Knutila. Number 99, Sala Karlainen.
All right, and for Rainy City Roller Derby All-Stars, we have 1-1 Faye Roberts, 1-6-1-8 Fred Finta, 2-7-3 Duck, 2-9 Penny Block, 3-1-1 Ella Diablo, 3-1-6 Lily Gaskell, 3-8 Blondie, 4-1-7 Stopless, 5 Lauren Swaffield, who is also the captain, 6 Rascal, 7 Mia, 7-7 Liz Yeatman, 8-1 Fairyquake, and 8-8 Banshee.
And that gives us some time to go over the officials' rosters. So our crew today includes non-skin officials Le Corbusier, John Brawls, Judge Booty, Big Brad Wolf, Diamond Tiara, This'll Be Painful, Masker Reed, Petey and Rule Booker, and O. Mias.
And for our skating officials, we have Razor, Refty Venue, PH Demon, Shanksy, Adam Smasher, RDFM, Jim Class Hero, and Chad Holderfield.
There you have it. That's everybody who will be on the track in the play area this morning.
So yesterday, we also had the roller derby, and we saw Helsinki face off against Loam. Of course, Helsinki coming out victorious in that.
Yeah, the score for that was 217-66.
And this is Rainy City's first game, actually, of the tournament, as they came in seed place 3.
Yes.
Yes,
it's true.
All true
actually,
facts.
Interesting things about these two teams. They've played 5 times since 2017.
Uh-huh.
Rainy has won 4 of the 5. The only time Helsinki has won was the very first time in April of 2017. And another fun fact, the closest game Helsinki's ever played, I'm going to throw it out there and say also Rainy, because this is a 1-point game, against these two teams together, and that was in 2017, 173-172. So, fun facts. The last time they faced off was in April of this year, and Rainy won 184-114.
Well, still a relatively tight score, so.
Oh, and they've had lots of time for footage.
Sure.
And the learnings. The learnings of the roller derby.
Researching your opponent in that.
So, yeah, remember, all these teams are competing for a spot in Champs in Montreal. That's November 15th through 17th. And they want to be top 3 in order to go to Canada.
Otherwise they won't be allowed in the country?
No. They just, would have to find a different reason to go.
That's fair.
But I hear bagels are very good in Montreal.
I've never been to Montreal, but I've enjoyed other parts of Canada.
Yeah. I've been to Montreal. It is a wonderful place. Okay, here we go.
Yeah.
We're playing roller derby.
Lauren Swaffield out for Rainy City, and Helsinki has Malu. A slow-moving pack as we approach the top of the first apex. And then, of course, they're going to have to bridge out a bit if they're going to go that far. I should point out Rainy City is in purple and Helsinki is in white. I should have said that earlier. Anyway, Swaffield is trying to press through the back of the pack, and her efforts are being matched by Helsinki's defenses. She's now been knocked to the inside and recycled back just about turn 2. Malu is having a very similar problem getting through Rainy City's blockade up front.
Yeah, it looks like Helsinki has an offensive blocker up front that just can't get enough space in there for that Helsinki jammer.
There has been a player block called on number 38 Blondie from Rainy City Roller Derby. Now on the far straightaway, we have elapsed the 1 minute mark without lead having been declared. So if this is
interesting right there, Helsinki just tapped out their offensive blocker. Like, the offensive blocker in the front wasn't having good time of it, went back, tapped a blocker, they swapped out, and then they did have a much better time of it, although there was still a recycle by that Helsinki jammer. Sorry, that was just kind of cool.
No, that's rad.
I haven't seen a whole lot of that. That was fun.
So now a minute and a half has gone, still no lead jammer for us. I'm kind of feeling like we're going to go the full 2 minutes before we get back to this jammer line, and maybe we just won't have... Oh, no. That's how the announcer curse works in reverse.
Says Malu, who's the lead now for Helsinki.
So Malu coming in. The pack has not moved away from turn three. Comes in for a first scoring pass, meets up with Rainy City's blockers midway through the pack. Just as Rainy City's Swafield got out, well before she was in scoring position, that jam was called. Helsinki did pick up 3 points.
So we're going to score to 3-0. If that was a preview of this whole game, it's going to be low scoring and very, very tiring for them, not for me.
No, I'm down. Yeah, I'm like...
I'm ready to go.
I had coffee. Everything's fine. All right. Fairyquake out for Rainy City. Mia for Helsinki. Now a little different from the last jam. Mia is going to be able to get out, get lead very quickly. At the same time, Fairyquake is out as well. The pack has already moved to turn three. As Mia enters, slides to the pack, and on one knee calls it off, but that is going to be a 0-0. Did not pass any opponents while in play, I suppose.
That did clear the penalty box. Oh, I'm speaking too soon.
What?
A blocker from Rainy City sitting down in the penalty box.
Oh.
It just cleared, and then at the very end, there was a penalty call. Here's the replay of this.
Whoa.
Apex jump, only one foot touching. She calls that off quickly and doesn't be able to pick up any points on it.
It is Mia out for Rainy City. Different Mia. There are two Mias. And Barbara Kunutila for Helsinki. We are just now leaving Apex 1. It is going to be Rainy City's Mia out as lead jammer of Barbara Kunutila. Also out, but well away from scoring position as Rainy City's Mia comes in, takes a little bit of a tumble, calls it off from the floor, but does pick up Rainy City's first 3 points. So in jam three, we're at 3-3.
Yes. Huh? Rainy City, though, already, you know, not, I wouldn't call it penalty trouble, but picking up the penalty pace is probably higher than they would like. They've had 4 so far in 3 jams. 0 so far for Helsinki. They're playing entirely clean, so I think that Rainy City isn't at full defensive capacity so far in this game.
That could be. But now the penalty box is emptied out. Ducky out for Rainy City. Kujala for Helsinki, and it is gonna be Kujala picking up lead for Helsinki Roller Derby. Back is around turn one. And that is enough time for Kujala to do a little apex hop, see if that gained any points. It is the full 4 available points in the meantime. And Ducky is still stuck in the pack, trying to get past the excellent wall that Helsinki is providing.
Helsinki is doing a good job of also placing their blockers appropriately inside the pack in order to open up kind of a lane for Kujala to go through. They did it again right here. Kujala is through for another 4 points.
Coming back in, Kujala about to come through scoring. There has been a star pass to Liz Yeatman in Rainy City as Kujala comes through and calls it off before Yeatman can get into scoring position. Another 4 points, making a 12-point jam for Helsinki, bringing their score up to 15.
Yeah, it's going to make the score overall 15-3. Here we get in the replay. Kujala able to go around the back of her teammate, then facing this one-on-one in the front, out-skating turning the blocker backwards. That's fun.
Style Thanks. Points.
I love it.
All right, next up, Lauren Swanfield for Rainy City and Nuki for Helsinki. An empty penalty box means we've got 5-on-5 on the track. Swanfield gets knocked into the inside and recycled back as the pack is about to pass over the pivot line. However, as Swanfield does find an open inside, does take lead jammer status. Star off and in hand, Nuki is now out as well, and the pack still has not gone over the top of the first apex. Jam is called. Looks like full 4 points for Rainy City, picked up 7-15.
Shout out to Right House Gates, proud sponsor of the 2019 WFTDA playoffs and championships. Thanks, Right House. Here in the replay, we see that lead being awarded right there. There's just a hole on the inside. You can't leave something like that if you don't want Swaffield to just walk right through it.
I'm going to point out that Tober just made a swimming motion.
I was swimming. It was a nice big open
and
lane.
I'm like, I want to play whatever derby you're playing, friend. Very quick out for Rainy City, but it's going to be Malu taking lead for Helsinki once again. And a jammer penalty on Very Quick, our first jammer penalty of the game. It's going to have her sitting in the box. That gives Malu a bit of an advantage. And, you know, this might be the jam we really pulled a wider score differential. I was kind of predicting this game to be fairly close.
Well, and the math and the predictors and probably the brackets that, I mean, none of them still survive.
I was saying mine from my heart. I'm not here to do math.
Well, you know what? I was going to say they would be predicting that Rainy City would be pulling ahead already, but Helsinki is just putting those points on the board, which is what you really, another eight total, 23 for them. What you really need to do, especially when you're playing a team that's ranked above you, it's like, oh, we're doing well, just pile on the points. So that later, if the team does adjust, you have a nice, good cushion.
Yeah.
There. A point cushion.
A point cushion.
Lounge
well
on your
featured
points.
On Tober's Etsy. They locked the jammer in the box. This Very Quick is stowed, and any second now it's going to come back into play. It's Mia from Helsinki. Mia in all caps, but I don't want to yell it at you. Helsinki Mia is in as jammer for Helsinki and is really having a hard time. All four of Rainy City's blockers up front.
Oh!
Giving her the what for, as it were. And that gives enough time for Very Quick. Fresh out of the box to pop through, boom, hey, guess what, I'm lead jammer, and everybody was like, oh.
That was Faye Roberts that blocked the Helsinki jammer Mia and gave the space for Very Quick to get that lead. It was a beautiful defensive move on the apex.
It was really nicely executed. There has been a star pass for the first time this game for Helsinki to Mayu Rinnick. The pack now coming around turn four. It is going to be called off. 2 points on that pass for Rainy, bringing a 6-point jam, 13-23.
It's going to bring this game to a 10-point difference. We've got 20 and a half-ish minutes left. Yep, here we go with the replay. You can see Mia going in there. There it is right there, that beautiful, beautiful blocking on the line by Faye Roberts. That's what you got to do. Take it all the way to the line and just shut it down. Close the door. No. None shall pass here.
No, thank you.
Yeah. You tricky jammer. And you're,
I'd just
and
rather not right now.
And you're hopping and you're bouncing. No.
All right. It is Mia for Rainy City. Varpu Kunutila for Helsinki. And it is going to be Rainy City's Mia taking a lead. Kunutila is now out of the pack, having completed her initial. But the pack hanging out about the top of the second apex right now. Rainy City's Mia comes in, calls it off from the front of the pack, does acquire all 4 available points.
It's going to be 3 in a row now for Rainy with points on the board, 17-23, under 20 minutes now left in the half. Penalty is still 0 for Helsinki, which is kind of notable, you know, to go 8 jams without a penalty. 6 total on the board for Rainy City. So they were able to kind of shut it down after those 4 penalties in the first 3 jams.
Ducky out for Rainy City. Kujala for Helsinki. Kujala more towards the back of the pack. Had been knocked to the outside. Is now knocked to the inside. And is going to be held behind. Penny block from Rainy City. along with two of her teammates. She does find an open outside, and that does allow to acquire lead for Helsinki.
Yeah, it appears that Kujala really enjoys the outside line. She skated before kind of like backwards around that other skater. She was just kind of doing it there. Then she kind of wants to make herself flat and just go whoop.
So there has been a star pass for Rainy City to Lily Gaskell, but the jam is going to be called before she can do anything with that. 4 points to Helsinki, 17-27.
Have you tried the Adam Savant wheel?
I haven't yet.
Well, you should see what you've been missing.
I would love to. Do they have a website, perchance?
AdamSkates.com. It's ATOM. Skate spelled the normal way.
It's like Adam, like the tiny thing.
Yes.
Not like some dude.
No.
Yeah.
Not Adam, but Atom.
No.
But I understand that my enunciation is not perfect.
Oh, so no, I thought that's where you were going with it.
Thank you for prompting me.
I like to take the joke a little too far, and that's where I was going. Lauren Swaffield out for Rainy City, Malou for Helsinki. It's going to be Swaffield taking lead as Swaffield approaches the pack. Helsinki's got a three wall out back. One of Rainy City's blockers trying to bust that up as her jammer approaches. It is not possible. So,
yeah.
By virtue of that wall existing, that jam is going to have to be called before any points could be maybe given up to Helsinki. A 2-point jam for Rainy City.
Yeah, it was a really good job there by Helsinki holding the two. Like, it was a braced three wall, and Rainy City was able to peel off the brace, but the wall didn't collapse.
So this is an official review called by Rainy City.
Derby Without Borders is a charity project dedicated to removing barriers to accessibility in the sport of roller derby. See how you can get involved at derbywithoutborders.org. Everybody's in the middle having a chat.
You got any news to tell me about tickets to Seattle, which is next weekend's playoffs? Can you give me that?
How did you read my mind like that?
I just know what's up.
The pack is here, so you can get a 4-pack of tickets. You can go with your friends to the 2019 International Playoffs in Seattle. That's next weekend in Washington. It's $175. That's $85 off the regular price for four. So you and three of your friends, a whole carload if you were carpooling, can go. So if you're planning on joining us in Seattle, make sure you get your tickets today.
So I did have a look at a little... Oop, what was it?
It's an official holding a microphone.
Okay. Thank you.
No, wait.
Oh, no. I think they're just taking it somewhere. Oh, I wonder if the battery's gone.
It's not working, yeah.
Okay.
It's an official holding a microphone and it not working.
We will eventually either relay it manually via our mouths or by official.
Yeah.
I did go to social media. I want to say hi to Grim Creeper, who says, the announcer said, I'm not here to do math while I'm doing math homework and watching the game.
Well.
You're there to do math.
Well,
I am not here to do math.
So
I feel like we have a bond, but it's a weird one.
Sometimes do math. But the math that I do is probably
math, much
easier than the math you are doing on your homework right now. I'm going to say, here we have a replay. Interesting. I wonder if that was foreshadowing. Oh, here comes it. I see
okay.
It. Okay, there's somebody with a microphone with new batteries. There's an announcer ref. But we will, at some point, we're going to tell you what's happening right now.
Are we good?
Look at that, if you like, man.
Is this just a battery change? Okay. Somebody's going to tell the producer, who is Ribby Longstocking, and Ribby will tell you, and then you will tell the people on the outside.
It's very true. I will...
So while that's going on, I want to point out Sonnet Boop has pointed out all of the possible Mias we could have. Mia Missile from Bear, Mia from Helsinki, Mia from Rainy, Mia Goham from Windy. There could be more Mias involved in our lives. Somebody set this up immediately. Immediately. Mia. Okay, you go.
Team Purple chose to use their official review. Purple Jammer, Purple 5, had been called on a multiplayer block. On review with multiple officials, there was a jersey grab. That link was challenged, so the multiplayer call will stand. Team Purple do not retain their official review. Thank you.
Thank you, Razor.
That's right from Razor. Do you have anything additional to add?
That was exactly what I was about to say.
I was just hoping someone could stop get me out of this Mia spiral.
So I'm assuming.
I can't.
I can't really see it.
I wasn't sure where to be looking. Okay.
Yeah, well, it was in the back, but that's why more officials than our cameras. And
sure, sure.
There's a reason for that.
And they've been doing that and doing a great job, so I'm going to believe them. Lauren Swaffield out for Rainy City Nuki for Helsinki. It is going to be Swaffield held in the box there. So I think this is the second jammer penalty perhaps for
yes,
Rainy.
It is.
Okay. So this is going to give Nuki the opportunity up front to gain lead, which has happened. Standing in the box is Swaffield. Swaffield has star in hand and is now re-entering the pack. We've got that three brace in the back that kind of, shut it down earlier. And so we'll see if that does the same again.
I think he's not able to hold Swaffield, who is now back in play.
All right, Swaffield. Not able to pick anything up there. 3 points for Helsinki, though. 19-30. So we still haven't seen a big, pull away. No.
Well, you could tell that both teams are working really hard to kind of get a feel for each other's defenses and break it apart. I think that Rainy City keeps kind of knocking away the brace from Helsinki, thinking that's going to collapse the wall. But Helsinki can still hold a two-wall without a brace.
Sure.
And so that's kind of stymieing that offense by Rainy City, and we'll see how they adjust to it.
Absolutely. Fairy Quake from Rainy City out and Mia from Helsinki. It is going to be Mia from Helsinki taking lead to Jammer Stennis. The pack is coming around turn one now and speeding up just a bit, causing Mia to do a little more skating before she can start making points of it. A little rough and tumble coming out of the top of the pack, but that is the full 4 points for Helsinki. Fairy Quake still trying to get out of the pack, essentially.
Yeah.
Thought there was... I don't know where she went because she took the star off, and this, I realize, is the point of that strategy, but to fool me, that's questionable.
Well... It's just unfortunate that it's in turn three, so you can't see anyone's numbers.
There was a lot. Yeah, there was a lot that was stifling me. She is the one in the back of the pack having trouble with the brace, though. Coming out of the front of the pack is Mia with Helsinki, not having trouble picking up another 4 points.
I was going to say, in the meantime, Mia decided nobody is slowing her down. Like, she hits that pack, and people are, blocking her, and she's, running with them, just taking them with her. Mm-hmm. Here we go for the first time in three passes. She's been slowed down a little bit. She's finally kind of stuck in the bad place.
There now has been a star pass. I was predicting it. Lily Gaskell once again taking it from Rainy City. And now the pack speeding up, coming now just across the jammer line as Mia, trying to call it from the back, does take an offensive block as the opposition comes through. 3 more points picked up by Helsinki.
It's going to be a 15-point jam.
All right. Looks like we are having a team timeout on behalf of Rainy City. So, what? Oh, can you tell me anything about statistics that I might follow from this?
I can't. Well, hold on. I'm going to watch this replay real quick.
Okay. Just a rough coming out of the pack. It looked so tiring to me, but they still come back full force every jam. Anyway.
It was pretty great. She predicted that those skaters would separate a little bit.
Yeah.
And whoop, I did the swimming thing again.
You did.
For some reason, I was
she's like, I'm sorry.
I imagine it like the little bloopy octopus in bloop, bloop, bloop. Okay. Follow along with live game updates and matchups at stats.wftda.com. You can forecast the game results, keep in touch with who's playing, who when, and see how the playoffs affect live rankings, all at stats.wftda.com. I use it all the time.
Yay,
obviously.
Stats. No, I love stats.
You
stats
should do it.
Stats so good. Mia from Rainy City, Kujala from Helsinki, and is going to be Oh, was the whistle a penalty? Yes, it was. So there are two Helsinki blockers in the back, and Box and Mia from Rainy City does now have lead. The track is not quite on top of the first apex, as Kujala is still trying to get through the back of the pack, trying to take the inside this time.
Yeah.
Does make it through. In the meantime, Rainy City's Mia trying to make a decision on when to call it off. Does go ahead and call it off well in advance of Helsinki being able to score any points. That was a 4-point jam for Rainy City. 0-point jam for Helsinki.
Brings the score at 13:30 to 45 for Helsinki, 23 for Rainy City. So far, we're still seeing Helsinki on top, which rankings and math and probably other people's intuitions did not predict.
Yeah. I'm with you. Ducky out from Rainy City. Varpu Kunitila out for Helsinki. And it is going to be Ducky taking lead. The pack is just now getting past the pivot line as Rainy City loses a blocker to the box that is stopless. Rabu Kunutila is also out, just about to come into the pack for scoring. Did not manage to pass anybody but her own blockers. 2 points more to Rainy City.
Helsinki's doing a really good job of limiting the number of scoring passes that Rainy City's jammers can. You can see in the replay here. That's beautiful. That's a way to get out and clean your initial pass.
Yeah.
Good job forcing that call off. Teeny tiny spaces. Like I was saying, they're able to hold Rainy City to kind of smaller scoring passes. Their highest scoring jam is 6 points.
Wow.
Whereas Helsinki's highest scoring jam is 15 points. So it's a very different looking jam when, even though Rainy City has about equal, yeah, they're exactly equal on amount of leads.
So now we're seeing a pretty long bridge for one human to take care of. I was really impressed for how long that could go. Lead does go to Lauren Swafield of Rainy City.
See how Swafield is able to do in this jam?
So as the pack comes up to the top of this apex, it's just like these two miniature swarms that have now joined into one giant swarm. Coming through,
I can explain all of roller derby right there. You're like, there's two small swarms, and then they smash together and become one swarm.
But they can disconnect again and become two smaller swarms. I had nowhere to take that analogy, and that's where
I know.
Yeah, sorry, but I'll work on my wordplay for later. Anyway, that was another two-point jam for Rainy City. We're seeing, as you pointed out, some very low-scoring point jams for Rainy City, but they are, I think it's been quite a few jams since Helsinki has scored, so it's working out in their favor.
There were three Helsinki jammers on the
Yeah, that happens, you know.
And now there's one, and it's Mia. Oh.
And now Mia's in the box, so.
She's there for a misconduct, it appears.
Is that right?
That's what the
true story.
That's what the little screen in front of me says.
Yeah, no, I wasn't trying to doubt you.
Oh, here we go. We have another jammer penalty. That is very quick.
So we're gonna do a little bit of a jammer switch, and so that puts Mia from Helsinki back in play. I don't think very quick will be seated terribly long.
No, and this will be a two-minute jam. Very quick, went to the box on a high block.
So there now has been a star pass on behalf of Helsinki. And that is going to be Latkainen taking the star. The pack formed on the far straightaway. Very quick is now re-entering play. Latkainen getting knocked to the inside is going to recycle back. Sparrowquake comes in and is not really having a lot of luck getting past the back of the pack, of course. We've repeatedly seen Helsinki doing a great job of guarding. In the meantime, Latikainen now headed to the box for the third jammer penalty of this jam on a back block.
And remember, this will be a two-minute jam, so we still have about 35 seconds left to go in it. And
whoa.
That was a beautiful hit.
I literally, all of my skin turned into goosebumps that was on that hit.
Banshee.
I got scared. And also, that was amazing. Hopefully there's a replay of what just happened with Fairy. Yeah, just replay this whole jam if you don't mind.
In slow motion,
Fairy Quig started to go out. She had her feet in and her hands out back, and then she was like, whoop. Yeah, so yeah. That's the only way to describe that is with noise.
Whenever anyone does that, I'm like, and my core can't.
Yeah, I was like, you know what, good for you. Clearly you have better control of time and space than I do, and your body. So 4 points for Rainy City, 2 points for Helsinki. An absolutely amazing jam to watch. She's that
beautiful,
devastating hit. And then
you're in my way.
Yeah, that was hardcore. And if there's a couple seconds longer, we will see.
Oh, here it is.
Down.
Oh,
well,
so close.
The next thing you would have seen is
stands right up.
Whoop.
Yeah. She's like, I've activated my core. Whenever they say that to me, like when I'm working out, they're like, activate your core. I'm like, eh.
I don't even have a core.
Somebody like that is like, activate your core, and they're like, whoop.
Yep.
I'm now standing upright.
Yeah. They stood up. Like a Helsinki has taken a time out.
Did you know the Radar Halo is now available in 103A hardness? Are you kidding me?
There's I didn't know that.
There's a halo for every surface. Beautiful, beautiful polished concrete. Sport court, if that's your thing. Outside. So check out Radar Halos.
All right, so I would like to point out, since we've talked about where you can look at the stats, the Wftda Bracket Challenge is still on. Of course, now that I started that, we're about to go back into play. I mistimed mine. Come back. Let's call that a cliffhanger. Say I did on purpose.
We'll be back.
Yeah. More on that later.
More on that. Actually, we've just...
The whistles. The whistles weren't to come
you.
Back.
The officials call their own little officials.
I should never doubt myself, but I do
second,
it all
you
the
know
time.
The second you start talking, the not your whistle is going to go
I
off.
I know. Slap you me know if what? They're going to talk. Okay. So the Wftda Bracket Challenge game is back. Enter your bracket predictions for the Wftda Continental Cup of Europe, International Playoffs in Seattle, and, of course, championships. Prove your derby know-how, predict results, and you could win the last pair of VIP tickets because they are already sold out for you and a friend to watch champs in person in Montreal and a Wftda.tv full postseason bundle. Visit derbyontoast.com to make your predictions, and may I then bring this full circle and say, perhaps you should check out stats.wftda.com.
Yeah.
Pow.
And you said you don't like math.
I do have to do a lot of math because I do like data science and stuff.
You do?
I've been doing 3D modeling and the amount of math that goes into that.
I don't know. I love it. Makes me nervous. Like,
yeah.
I have a math anxiety. It's funny because
nobody's
I'm always
watching
like,
me.
Here I am doing math.
Yeah.
It's not the people watching me. It's the numbers in my brain.
Oh.
But you know what? I still do. I do it for you guys.
Don't be afraid of it. And I just don't. I just refuse to do it for you guys. So who's your friend here? It's Toby.
I mean, was that ever in question?
It wasn't. It wasn't. I've got a villain face. Anyways, Rainy City has Mia out. Kujala from Helsinki. I mean, Kujala absolutely flying through. Taking lead. Mia from Rainy City picking up a track cut, so it's going to be yet another jammer penalty, which I will check on this in a bit, but I'm feeling like the jammer penalties are pretty heavy for Rainy City at this point.
Yeah, this is a wild ride. Mm-hmm. It looks like
5, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Wasn't using my fingers for the record.
Yeah, and only one, and only, and five. Oh, wow, it was a lot of box trips. So.
Oh my gosh! Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, so there's 5 on one, and 6 on the other. Anyways, stood in the box is Rainy City's Mia, as we are just about to turn 3 with the pack. A little spin move from Kujala. She's going to come out, picking up the full 4 points. Rainy City's Mia now re-entering. That was the initial very cleanly and quickly done. As you will notice, there is one blocker from each team in the pack, so maybe a slight advantage, question mark. 4 points called off. Kujala going to do another style point, having call off, calling it off backwards.
That is a 12-point jam for Helsinki. It's Rainey still hasn't put a jam up that was larger than 6 points, which is, you know, I'll call it a multi-pass because obviously it's two, but...
Well, I feel like
That was really cool for Faye to see it. She was, like, down, like, crouched, and then Sivica,
I feel like there were several jams in a row that Helsinki didn't pick anything up, and they just sat at 45, sat. And they're like, by the way, we can do these big points jams. Yeah. Don't forget that. Okay, well, let's resume. Ducky out for Rainy City has taken lead. But Nuki from Helsinki is also out. I suspect a call-off will be shortly forced. Yeah, I don't think... Yeah, 1 point called as Ducky turned around to see Helsinki's jammer coming at her and went ahead and called it off. There is an official review.
We do.
Called by Helsinki.
Do you know the symptoms of a concussion and the return-to-play protocol you and your teammate should be following? You should visit WFTDA.com/concussions for resources and information on this silent injury. Don't forget the WFTDA has released new concussion risk clarifications on how to manage concussion risk. So go check those out.
Yeah, and they're really important because, like, adults feel the symptoms of concussions potentially later than you like, the older you get, the later it may take, and they can turn into, like, long-term effects. So it's something you really should be taking seriously, and I'm happy the WFTDA has provided information on that.
I agree. And if you think about the amount of time and money and energy you put into your brain.
Team White have chosen to use their official review. Team White is asking for a back block call on Purple Jammer due to contact with White 77.
All right.
If you think about the amount of money and time and effort you invest into your brain, you'd want to protect that.
I keep all of my memories in it.
Yes.
And so I tend to watch out for it.
Yeah, I agree with you.
Yeah.
I also think about, like,
I forget to back up a lot.
Here is the
potential. Uh-huh. This is the 1 point that she made it past. And all right. So we'll be back shortly with what the officials saw on that official review.
Nothing conclusive in it, so
I got nothing.
I looked at that and I was like, well, I'm glad that I'm not the official reviewing that, although they can't see the footage, so even better.
No, I would just be nervous and be like, is it cool if I just go home? Because this is a lot.
It's a lot of things happening.
Yeah.
Here we go.
And that's why I trust other people. It's just, I especially trust Razor, who I now don't live terribly far away from, but I pretty much only see in the USA. I've seen her one time in the UK.
How many people is that true for you, where you're like...
I don't get out a lot.
You live a couple of hours from me, but I only see you in convention centers in America.
I've seen more of my USA friends since I moved to England than I did when I was in the USA, and I'm not complaining, because I'm like, that's cool. But is this kind of like, y'all wouldn't drive a half hour? You're going to fly to a different country? Okay. No.
During the course of the official review and discussion with officials, it is determined that the contact to White 77 was mainly to the side that is legal. So the no call will stand.
So they will not retain their official review. There are no more official reviews left in this half. We're going to watch this again. Yeah, I see that.
All right, so we are about to get back into the action. And it's going to be Lauren Swaffield out for Rainy City. Malou for Helsinki. And Malou, I mean, this official review has allowed everyone to regain full energy. So Malou hung up at the back of the pack. They are stretching, becoming the longest pack.
The longest pack. And out of play being called on Alu.
And so, Rainy City's Lauren Swaffield is now through, does have lead. Malou is out, but about a quarter of the way the track behind as Lauren Swaffield approaches the pack. Does attempt, of course, to enter and get points, but does not manage to pick up any. So it's going to be a 0-0 jam. We are still sitting 32-59, and we are approaching just 5 minutes left in this half.
Yeah, now's the time that you're really starting to think about, okay, what's my strategy going into halftime? Like,
what's the mood, what is going to be the, you know, the general feeling of the team as we go to do the hard work that you got kind of that only 10 minutes to do. So it's going to be where you're going to push for momentum shift if you're a rainy city. And you're going to push to keep adding points if you're Helsinki, because that 10 minutes in the locker room can really change things.
Definitely. Talking about changing things, Fairy Queen's got lead, and I feel like she has dreams in her heart, and those dreams are for points. Will she achieve these dreams? Let's see. She comes up on the back. They do have the Helsinki's three race that has been guarding the back. She does pick up 2 points. So I'm going to call those dreams realized.
Ooh, it's three. There was a thumb.
Oh.
A thumb.
To 35-59 as we get down to the last few minutes of this half. See a replay of them getting out of the top of the pack, narrowly avoiding that last hit from Helsinki. Yeah.
A little bit of jostling in the pack before we start. We've got Kuyala up against Mia from Rainy City. Kuyala looking for a line.
Mia from Rainy City taking a substantial fall. It just didn't look pleasant. Does come back in full force. Kuyala, in the meantime, has already picked up lead, I believe, by taking that outside, which has been her favor. Mia still working to get through, looking to the inside, looking to the center, looking to the outside. Eventually, she will find that lane. Kuyala coming through. That is the first scoring pass. Picks up the full 4 points as the pack comes around, now hanging out at turn two. Kuyala coming in a little bit of a
I think those points counted.
Yeah, just doesn't look like it. So that was 4 points for Helsinki. Yeah, and nothing picked up that time. My rainy city, but A for effort. Kuyala just doing an amazing job. Yeah, I feel like she did take lead on the inside at least one time, but the outside is like her domain.
She just sees the lines out there so clearly.
Yeah. So Ducky from Rainy City, Mia from Helsinki is very quickly going to be Mia from Helsinki taking lead and coming in. The pack has not even had the opportunity to pass over the pivot line as they swarm around Ducky, who's just trying to live her life.
Mia again decided, I'm not being slowed down. That's how she has her jamming style is just sheer force of will. I'm walking through his pack, taking these 4 points, going home, sitting down. Roller derby equipment issues can be caught by a quick inspection of gear using the new WFTDA guide for equipment check. Get a copy now at resources.wftda.com. Check out how to check your gear, stay safe, and protected.
All right, Lauren Swafield out yet again for Rainy City. It's Malu for Helsinki, Rainy City's pivot number 88. I looked at the wrong 88. Banshee is in the box because I was like, that is not right. Banshee's still in the box, about to re-enter play. Malu has taken lead once again for Helsinki. Lauren Swafield was out, but before she can get into scoring position, it is called off. However, Helsinki did pick up those full 4 points. Tober.
Yeah, Helsinki doing a good job of either having those big jams when they have lead and have time, or when, you know, just keeping Rainy City to small amounts, not risking it, either risking getting a penalty or risking giving up points. And if you're looking at jam, you know, Helsinki has had lead jammer 10 times, Rainy City 12. It was a little bit more lopsided, but in the last 5 jams or so, Helsinki's really kind of brought that back into parity.
Absolutely. Fairyquake out there is going to blast through the middle of the pack. Does take lead for Rainy. Noogie, in the meantime, not having as good a luck getting through. We are just now rounding the top of the first apex and stopping at turn two. A little spin move there from Fairyquake. She is through and picking up 4 points for Rainy City. That far straight away I believe the star has been passed, or maybe they're just really mad at the pivot. Nope, I guess they're just really mad at the pivot. That's fine, you know.
Sometimes you want to still... You could also be protecting the star pass, but...
It's true.
The
I'm
pivot.
Just like, your emotions are your own, and I'm not here to tell you what to do. So I was trying to predict something, and I failed. Fairy Quake, however, I can predict will pick up this for more points, and perhaps... Even more, the period clock has expired, but we do have 50 seconds left on the jam clock, as Fairy Quake has control of whether we see all 50.
It's a back block being called on Fairy Quake. This is going to now end in a two-minute jam. We have 40 seconds left. I don't believe Nikki's completed her initial pass yet,
though. She has
though.
Not. That's
so,
true.
Yes.
That's why I was like, are you going to pass the star? It doesn't look like it. So, yeah, coming back in for another recycle there is Nuki. He's just fighting for the last remaining few seconds of this jam.
I think the pivot's holding the star cap.
I don't. She wasn't earlier.
No, but she is now. It
yeah,
just happened. It
that's
literally
okay.
just happened.
So Latakainen does have yeah. possession of the star, just doesn't have it on her head.
Yes.
So they must have been guarding it
like,
earlier.
She
okay.
went out of my view. Like two blockers were in front of her,
sure.
and then they parted again, and she was
yeah,
holding
yeah.
it. So I'm like, I missed it.
Fair. All right, so I think someone may have called, what was it, timeout called or something? Oh, no, I guess not. So a replay here. We can see Fairy Quake. Amazing control of her feet doing that spin to come out and has picked up all four of the points.
What probably makes you a good jammer is if you played that game, The Floor is Lava, a lot as a kid. Because you're like, okay, I'm going to put 1 foot here, and then 1 foot here, and then my body over here, and contort in a way that no one's ever seen, and now I'm out.
So if you'd like to raise a future jammer, just remind your children that the floor is lava.
The floor is lava.
We will be back for the second half of this game in about 12 minutes.
Yep, score is 71-47. See you back then.
Welcome back to the second half of, I don't know why I had to look at the scoreboard, it's rainy city versus Helsinki. I'm Julia Sleezer, joined by the wonderful Tober. And Alan? We went into the half, Rainy City 47, Helsinki 71. Can I tell my kind of complex one first?
Yes, please do.
So, some of you were asking on Twitter what the misconduct on number 156, Mia from Helsinki, was. There, so you noticed the three jammers on the track.
Yes, there were three jammers on the track.
So what has happened was, having one jammer clearly established as what the opponents were going to see as this is probably going to be the jammer, and then swapping her out after the five-second call was clearly an attempt to deceive, according to officiating, and thereby unsportsmanlike. So
oh.
the penalty should be assessed to the captain, but I think may have erroneously been assessed to the jammer for swapping out. So there should be a reassignment of that. But yeah, it was a little more complex than I thought it was going to be. I was like, hey, y'all, what's that misconduct about? And they were like, words, 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 words.
That's interesting.
So I brought them back.
People do that all the time. They swap up. I didn't realize that if you do it after the 5 seconds.
It's something that I think is being recently reviewed under as we examine more situations that could be considered unsportsmanlike.
That's an interesting conversation to have in the sport. Like, when is deception strategy and when is deception unfair?
Yeah. Or just,
interesting.
When is your deception too deceiving?
Too deceiving.
Join us at this TED Talk.
Like, when you used to, like, ball up the helmet cover and now you can't do that anymore. And, like,
yeah, you're, like, hiding it
like
in
this.
Your hand. Yeah.
I'm not the jammer.
Not me.
So if the refs don't know you're the jammer, then it's even worse. Anyway, what I was going to say is I was kind of trying to figure out what's been going on in this game, why Helsinki has been so successful, and Rippy, our producer, pointed out that every time a Rainy City jammer gets lead, the next time they're on the track, they get shut out. So Helsinki's doing a really good job of figuring out the jammer's likes and dislikes mm-hmm. and adjusting to it, whereas Kujana has, you know, scored almost all the points, 32 points for Helsinki, and has been able to kind of consistently take a line on the outside or on the inside. To do that, we have Mia. Oh my gosh! Pleaser, look at the jam.
Hello, it's a Mia versus Mia. I never thought this day would come, but here we are.
Mia is lead.
Well, Mia is still stuck in the pack.
Mia is still trying to fight past the opposition's wall. Which Mia is it? This is when you have to look at the TV, actually. It's Mia from Rainy City that does have lead. Has just come out on the first scoring pass. Mia from Helsinki still stuck in the pack.
And you gave in so soon. I thought we'd go like half the jam like that.
I don't know
like
if my deception is unsporting. Is it very funny? Am I hurting you?
Speaking of things happening, Latikainen is now the jammer for Helsinki, so it's no longer a Mia versus Mia jam.
From Helsinki, not Latikainen from Rainy City.
Yes.
That was my...
If there was a Latikainen in Rainy
make
City,
it,
that would be like...
Joke. It did not land.
I was like, wait, did I say it wrong?
No.
A joke. No. It's cool.
Yeah.
It's cool. We're back. Welcome back.
Yeah.
Good morning. Rainy City heard me saying that their highest scoring jam was 6, and they're like, that doesn't sound very good.
Yeah.
And so they've come back from the half, and they're like, I'll have multi-passes.
Yeah.
And they've got their,
I don't know if that was the best way to enter the pack,
multi-pass.
But it is certainly a way to enter the pack. Worked out. Just a little fearful for safety there for a second. It just didn't look awesome. Coming out of the top of the pack is Rainy City's Mia. Being actually blocked finally by Helsinki's Mia. It's going to take Mia to the outside. So it is continues to be a face-off of the Mias to the very end of the jam. A 16-point jam for Rainy City.
Now the highest scoring jam in the game. So Rainy City decided that they needed to put points up in order to make this a more competitive game. Here you go. You can see. Oh, yeah. Finding that outside line, speeding around. Beautiful.
Yeah, some really well-executed strategy. So we can see the penalty has been reassigned from Helsinki's Mia down to the captain, Sarah Eckholm.
Oh, yep, I see it.
Yeah.
That was some great blocking work you saw in the replay by Stopless. Looks like we're in official timeout. It's a great time to talk to you about quick. When you need to roll quick, think quick. Quick bearings, where precision meets performance. So if you need new bearings and you do, everyone knows that annoying noise on the track is your skates.
Wow.
Get some quick.
Called out. Yeah. So we are currently... I suppose on an official timeout still in it. I thought it was about to swap out, and it did not. So,
score is 63-75. So with that 16-point jam, this becomes a much different conversation we're having. Though, sometimes these OTOs can really either break momentum of a team who's kind of on an upswing, or it can give them more momentum. It's really hard to tell.
Regardless, there's dancing on the jam line, so I don't really have a lot more to ask from this game.
That's the best. I really love dancing.
I don't.
Well, I mean,
I like to watch
to dance. Yes, I like when people dance.
Yeah, like the whole thing in Guardians of the Galaxy was like, there are dancers and there are people that do not dance, and I'm like, I am super seen right now.
Yeah?
Like,
you're a people that do not dance?
I'm a people that do not dance. And no. I guess that says something about me. I'm not clear on what. Anyway, it looks like we are still having some discussion now, looking to the outside pack refs for some feedback, and I'm sure Razor will be back with us shortly to tell us thingamabobs about that. So the WFTDA's Diversity and Inclusion Committee is looking to expand its members. Special consideration will be given to those applicants from underrepresented groups. Find out more and apply at resources.wftda.com.
We'll be bringing you continued coverage of the 2019 WFTDA postseason from the WFTDA Continental Cups and through the International WFTDA Championships in November. There are several different watch passes available at WFTDA.tv, so find the one that suits you best.
log in to join us live as the action unfolds. And remember, next weekend, we'll be coming to you from Seattle, Washington.
Yeah. I love the Pacific Northwest.
I know you do.
Yes. It's wonderful.
I don't love it that much because it's damp, but it's so pretty.
It's actually, like, I was surprised the humidity there is so much less than anywhere else I've lived. Although, like, I'm like, but I can also see the ocean. What a lovely place to be. So still ranking pretty high in my heart. And my friends are there. Who can say?
Well,
who can say? Anyway, so we've got Ducky out for Rainy Sea, Malou out for Helsinki. Only one blocker in the box. That is a Helsinki blocker number 12. 112, I believe, yes.
Fuchs.
So this is going to be hard fought to get through the pack. You can see that Rainy City's three brace up front.
What you can't see is Rainy City's jammer tying her skate.
Oh! Oh my gosh, yeah, off to the side. Well, you know, what I do see now, though, is a penalty being assessed to Malou.
That's a misconduct.
It is, in fact.
I don't know what that one is, though.
No,
I was too busy watching. I was too busy watching Ducky tire skate.
It's true. I don't know if I'll be able to catch what that one's about unless we have time and I see the Danger Muffin is available. I may try to grab that one as well. So coming into the pack, Ducky being an absolute force to be reckoned with in this game. Coming up again for another scoring pass. The pack, of course, not going particularly fast, so she's just relying on how quickly she can do her own laps to re-meet with points. Rainy City up front doing a great job of holding Malou, who had come out of the box star in hand and tried to sneak on through, but was detected.
8 points total on that jam, 71 to 75. We now have a 4-point difference in this game. And whatever adjustments that Rainy City did in the locker room have worked, because a team that didn't have a single jam where they scored more than 6 points came out and put up a 16-point jam, an 8-point jam. So, there's only been two jams. Yes, so that's a lot of points very quickly is what I'm trying to say.
You're doing great, buddy.
I'm trying.
I adore you. Fairyquake out for Rainy City, but it's going to be Nina Irwiss with hot on her heels, though. Fairyquake just maybe like 8 feet behind.
I believe that's Nina Irwiss's first time jamming?
Is
that really?
Not her? Ever. But, well, like, no. In the game. Yeah,
because it's not her.
Maybe you're right.
Yeah, it's Kuyala.
Oh, was it misattributed on the...
It was misattributed on the scoreboard, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, we're not just trying to deceive you. I did, actually. I'm thankful to Riggs listening from the UK for pointing out there are people that are only listening on the audio stream.
Oh, yeah.
And so... She's called it the cheap seats, but I'm just like, you know, you're the multitaskers.
Yes. Sometimes when I'm at work, I only listen, so I have a...
I sometimes have the stream on, and I'm listening while I'm doing something else. So I appreciate it. So thank you for reminding me, Riggs, that...
Good reminder to tell you the score. It's 73 to 75.
Yeah, we're getting really close.
25 minutes left in the game.
Lauren Swaffield, yet again out for Rainy City, is getting knocked into the inside, recycled back. The pack is still behind the pivot line, though, and really quite thick. Trying to stay upright, but it just didn't work out. Lauren Swaffield, again, knocked into the inside. Feeling like the inside lane is not for her this time, but she tries again.
Nuki is just trapped in the bad place. It's brace three wall in the back.
So Swaffield does pick it up, and coming into the pack there for the first scoring pass, yeah, it's just not going to be easy. Now, this time she did try to take to the outside. Perhaps she is to be shut out of all lanes. But I believe in her.
Do you?
I do. I believe in all of these people. I have a lot of belief.
You should. They're doing
wonderful
job.
Yeah, no, they're doing, yeah, like, I'm double super impressed, so.
Two to beat in the front now as we go into turn three. Three, there's the
third
reason.
There was a secret blocker. She was down that low.
I know, she popped back up, and I was like, oh.
Yeah. Oh, oh. Yep.
So, you know, that's how you know I live in the Midwest, and I'm like, oh, yes. Sorry there.
Midwest
sorry there.
Representing. Now just that in the final Yeah, Liz Yeatman.
Yeah.
Oh, holding back single-handedly. So it's 3, 2, 1, release. And that is going to acquire 4 points for Rainy City. Nothing picked out for Helsinki, but not by lack of effort.
And this is a lead change, 77-75, here on the replay. Defying physics.
Skarmanage Hugs posted a gif of somebody drinking a Coke, if you all remember that reference from a few years back. Pictured here, Rainy City during the half. You can check out the amazing tweets that we see and also leave us your own messages at hashtag #talk2WFTDA on the Twitter. In the meantime, Mia from Rainy City does get through a no pass, no penalty, is not awarded her lead, so that's going to be still open to Varpu Kunatila, who is now battling the final two Rainy City blockers up at the top of the pack, which is Liz Yeatman and Faye Roberts.
Lead now awarded to Helsinki. We were both like, look, it's a lead.
She got
jammer.
Done, and she was like, yeah, yeah. But yeah, just a hard fought to get that lead. In the meantime, Mia from Rainy City is in scoring position in the pack. I mean, although, you know, she doesn't have lead, that, you know, it's not going to stop her from scoring some points. She's having a heck of a time, though, against Helsinki's 3 brace up front. And now a friendly face, stopless, attempting to help her through.
Yeah. Okay, this is a great gamble that Helsinki made. That was beautiful up at the front. Who is that? Is Fuchs with the beautiful reset. I mean, just one of those last-minute clear-outs, but it worked. See, this is a great gamble that Helsinki made, deciding not to call the jam off immediately. A lot of the times when you're a lead second like that, you will just call it right off.
Right, right.
But, you know, they're at least going to break even on this jam, I think.
Mm-hmm.
And they gave themselves some time maybe to score more points. We'll see what they decide to do.
Well, we've got about 15 seconds left where they can, well, they're going to go ahead and be done with it. It is, in fact, as you said, going to be a 4-4, which is going to make it Rainy City 81. Helsinki will then be at 79.
Ooh.
There is a team timeout on behalf of Helsinki.
All of the really good close games are in the morning. You should tell your friends they should always watch the first game of the day. Because yesterday you would have seen a 12-5 upset. Today you're seeing a real close game. Like, if you're not up in the morning watching the 10 a.m. game, you're just missing the best games of the day.
The thing is, you know, Manchester right now, it's like 4 p.m.
Is it the same time in Helsinki?
I think that's off. It's an hour or two, so it's going to be like, yeah, they're in the evening.
Yeah, they're playing at the best time of day.
Just look for the first game of the tournament because, I mean, it's morning for me. I don't know what your life holds.
Don't forget, you can be part of the hashtag Champs3000 crew. VIP tickets already sold out, but there are still 3-day passes available for the 2019 International WFTDA Championships in Montreal, November 15th through 17th. Don't miss your chance to join us in person for this monumental event. You can get tickets at wftda.com/tickets.
So this has turned into an official timeout while we have the referees and other officials check on a few things.
The S1 Lifer visor helmet is next level protection. You should check them out.
I'm about the visor. I'm all about the visor.
I used to work at a organization that certified ophthalmological technicians, and I had to QA their videos, and I had to watch one on sports injuries to the eye. Yeah, wear a visor.
You know what? Let's not Google that, friends.
No, just don't. Just
anyway,
don't.
Do, however, know that Rainy City's Ducky is out, does have lead. Helsinki's Mia is, is nearly through. She does have the star in hand. She's going to be recycled back behind Banshee. However, Fuchs is now back in play, having come out of the box and already breaking up Rainy City's defenses, trying to help her teammate through at the top of the pack. Ducky trying to fend off the final two Helsinki blockers, and it is just a rough go. Latikainen, the last to contend with, she does get through. That is picking up another 4 points for Rainy City.
Just the sheer like core and leg strength it takes to stay in balance when you've got two blockers like pushing as hard as they can up against your feet are on the rope. It's just Rainy City's been doing such a good job in the second half of just staying in balance. Another 2 points, going to be six total, 87 to 79. We have 19:50 left on the clock. Here you can watch in this replay. That blocking up at the front. And there it is, up, step out of bounds. Big recycle. So when you're a jammer, that's really your the big fight is to keep your feet in bounds. And the big fight if you're a blocker is to make sure they don't.
Fairy Quake out for Rainy City. Malou out for Helsinki. A completely empty penalty box as the pack stretches a bit over the first apex, but it's going to have to whip on back as Fairy Quake is out of the pack, does have lead, and meets up with them again where she left him at turn one. Straight through the pack, not a lot of resistance there. That is 4 points for Rainy City. The pack now standing at the top of the apex. That was not a pleasant-looking pass to the pack as Fairy Quake meets one of Helsinki's blockers rather roughly through and is recycled back behind Salikainen.
Getting a lot of help from Lily Gaskell. Lily Gaskell basically just opening up holes, make lines like Swiss cheese in that pack. Allows Fairy Quake to pick up 4 points.
Coming in yet again for this third scoring pass. Fairy Quake is just not having that hard of a time getting through this time. I feel like Helsinki's forgotten to guard the back of the pack recently.
No, Lily Gaskell is just banging people around in there. So, like, while there's the three wall holding back the Helsinki jammer, the offense is Lily Gaskell with the pivot helmet on, and it just Helsinki is not able to stop her.
That's fair.
From knocking them apart. And in the first half, Helsinki is doing a great job of kind of keeping their wall together even when their brace got knocked away.
Sure.
They're not having as easy a time in the second half, so whatever adjustments to blocking then Rainy City decided to make is working.
Faye Roberts doing a great job there for a long time, being like sole effort to hold back two of Helsinki's blockers, which can make a huge difference when you have, you know, clearly this level of blockers. Now that is Malou finally through, having completed her initial. Fairy Quake out of the pack on the last scoring pass. That was 4 more points. I think that might have been the actual natural conclusion of that jam, was it not?
Yeah, it was 20 points. I think it was, too.
Okay.
But it was over in the corner. I
know.
Because the refs are in my way. I'm really short.
They're not in your way. You just decided to be this short, so, like, you know.
Look at this. Look at this, Fairy Quake.
Ah. Whoa.
Okay, so if anybody in your freshman program is like, why do I need to do core work? Just show them that 5 seconds of roller derby and be like, that's why. Can you do that? No? Okay, go. Do core.
Kuyala out again for Helsinki and taking lead. The pack now at turn one and rather thick. The penalty box remains empty. So as you pointed out earlier, for both teams, this has been fairly low penalty getting game.
Well, and it's interesting because in the first half, Rainy City had a lot more penalties.
Just for like a while, though, yeah.
In the second half right now, Helsinki has a lot more penalties. So it's kind of interesting how that might play out in the score, maybe.
Perhaps. So star in hand, Lauren Swaffield is out and will soon be in scoring position. Kuyala, not interested, calls it off. That's going to be 4 points total. 4 points total for Helsinki. No. 6 points.
Yes. It's two more, yes.
Yes.
Six points.
I suddenly was like, which team is which color? Okay. Helsinki got 6 points total. Rainy City picking up nothing. We see in the replay here. And that is, just absolutely narrowly missing these blocks. Yeah. Incredibly impressive.
So don't forget to check out adamskates.com for the latest in gear.
Mia versus Mia. It is going to be Rainy City's Mia, just like the last Mia versus Mia jam, taking lead. But this time, Helsinki's Mia does get out rather quickly. And so I imagine, well, now I know there won't be a star house. How's that?
Is it because it's the end of the jam?
Yeah, that was it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That was what, yes.
Prompted
afterwards,
you know.
You're just handing someone the star. It doesn't count for anything.
Then you're just the bench manager.
Yeah, at that point, actually, there's also just no rules. You can just literally hand it to anyone. Just, here you go. Here
you're
you go.
The jammer
just
now.
Give it to somebody on the street. Be like, here you go, kid. Have a good life.
Like,
they'll be like, okay.
Why do I need this weird, stretchy
weird
shower cap?
Where is my mother? You know, et cetera. Yeah. Anyways, ducky out for Rainy City, Kujala out for Helsinki. As we get down under halfway through this last half, Kujala taking lead. The pack is just beyond the pivot line at this point. Star in hand, ducky is now through.
Interesting, we're seeing now we're seeing Kujala come back every other jam. Makes sense. Kujala has the largest differential, so points scored that, you know.
Sure.
An answer, 38 points total, 34 in the differential. It's a smart move.
Also, zero penalties on Kujala, so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And if I'm on the Heels Helsinki bench, and I'm looking at the time and the score, I'm saying, you think you can go again?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
109-89, so a 20-point game. Rainy City's still on top. 14 minutes left in the game.
All right, so Fairy Quake out for Rainy City. Mia for Helsinki. Still an empty penalty box here. Mia trying to get past the back of the pack. She thought she was going to be able to, but stopless. Just coming at her.
Coming. Yep, definitely. I saw it. It was on the outside. I saw it in the outside. Packraff saw it, but you saw it in the inside. Packraff didn't, so that shows like where the angle was on it.
I see. Well, Fairyquake still in the action, and now met with a three wall up front from Helsinki. Broke it up a little more easily this time than has been in the past, and Fairyquake is going to pick up those 4 points. Come in for another scoring pass as the pack is stretched along the far straightaway. Got the three brace up front again of Helsinki, a little more effect this time, holding her back. That was number 51.
Yeah, Alu. With a little help from Sarah Ekholm kind of guiding her over. It was good teamwork.
Sure.
And we'll see, it's continuing here with Ekholm and two blockers who are facing me. I can see their faces and not their numbers.
So all four of Helsinki's blockers watching up front while Mia from Helsinki struggling in the back against Rainy City's defenses. She was almost through, tripped a bit and fell to the inside, and to avoid any sort of track cutters. Take to the back. Knocked out fairly squarely to the outside. Again, recycling back behind Stopless. In the meantime, Fairyquake picking up 4 more points, and as the pack passes over the pivot line now, is going to be coming in for another scoring pass. There has been a star pass to Mayurine from Helsinki.
Yeah, a name that I feel like I'm not saying enough is Lily Gaskell, who's just keeping the jammer from Helsinki stopped up, although, you know, obviously there was the star pass, allowed the jammer to get out, allowed some points to be scored. Mm-hmm. 8 total on the jam for Rainy City, 2 for Helsinki, 117-91, and we're seeing an official review being called by Helsinki.
It's true.
The S1 Lifer helmet, best fit plus superior protection, equals made for roller derby. Get a lifer, be a lifer. And don't forget to Derby Without Borders' unique equipment distribution program that collects new and used gear to donate to roller derby leagues who need it across the planet. Find out how you can help support at derbywithoutborders.org.
Having a peek at the social media, as the kids enjoy. Princess Murdenoki, this is my favorite right now. If Fairyquake was a Ben & Jerry's core ice cream, that core would be made of solid concrete surrounded by the sweetest ice cream. It would not be a soft, I would be a soft, squishy caramel core. Not quite the same, but close, but not really. And I feel like we have a lot in common.
I think I am
actually mostly made of marshmallow.
I was going to say mine is cookie dough. Like, if you squeeze it, it just goes... But it's delightful all around.
But you know what? Fairyquake's doing great.
Team Helsinki has chosen to use their official review. They are requesting for a back block call on Purple Jammer 8-1.
I would also
We were complimented on knowing time zones, and I'm actually pretty proud about that.
Well.
Yeah. I said I wasn't here to do math, and that I was doing it in secret.
I mean, you also are jet-lagged, let's be fair.
I'm actually not. I'm doing
really?
Great. No, like, it's 7 a.m. is noon in England, so I'm all like, what's up, guys? I'm awake. Because my sleep schedule is garbage.
Yeah, it's true.
So, yeah. I go to sleep at, like, 4 in the morning in England, which is, like, depending on which USA time zone I'm in, it's actually a normal hour. It would be, like, 11 p.m. here.
So you just never adjusted. You just moved to the UK and stayed on the US.
No, I was doing okay for a while, and then I don't know what happened. I don't have, like, a set schedule I have to follow right now, so it's just, like, if I'm being real, it's, like, RuneScape for, like, 12 hours a day, and then I'm like, better go to sleep. Maybe I'll do something tomorrow, and then I just haven't. I will someday, though, but... I mean, I'm on World 84 if you guys want to go fishing or something.
We just saw a replay of the moment in question.
Mm-hmm.
I see some movement on the inside, so I think we'll get an answer soonish.
So Razor is now telling the benches...
And then we get to find out.
Then we get to find out.
It's so much suspense. I love official. I could love a good official review because you can, like, watch the information move. Like, they have their little, you know, their little, like, pitches. You can pitch.
Well, I like it when I get the information, but I have to, like, hold on to this secret while the benches find out. And I'm like, I already know.
But I know your future.
That's not today for me. Rippy does actually know.
But Rippy knows. Oh, here we go. I see a microphone.
Razor gonna call
us. Do it.
Let's do it. Razor, Razor, Razor.
The outcome of the review called by Team Helsinki is that the contact from Purple 81 with their shoulder was legal. So the no call stands and they do not retain the official review.
All right, thank you very much, Razor. Interesting, like, conversation about whether or not when you don't have video replay to take official reviews on penalties. Because I feel like if the officials saw it the way you saw it, although, yeah, that is shoulder to side as far as I can tell. Yeah. But if the officials saw it the first time, they would have called it?
Yeah. I mean, you know, it's...
Every once in a while you get one.
Sure.
I don't know.
You
I don't know.
It is what it is, and what this is Lauren Swanfield out for Rainy City, Emily out for Helsinki. That was the smoothest transition any of you have ever heard. On the far straightaway, absolutely, oh, I thought she was going to just run that outside and nearly did. Had to take a bit into the middle. That is Swanfield taking lead for Rainy City. Swanfield about to come in on Swapfield. First scoring pass meets that brace that Helsinki had been holding so well in the first half of this game, just absolutely guarding the back, and we see it renewed here. Also, Malou having to mow past the final two blockers of Rainy City.
That was a beautiful job that Rainy City did. Sweeping to the inside and giving a avenue for that jammer to get through.
See that replay. Almost running through on that outside and just has to, like, pop in. She's like, fine, if I can't have that lane, how about the lane right next to it? How do you feel about that? I feel pretty good. Got lead. And, you know. I assume that's the conversation that happened. I have no real evidence of this.
I mean, that seems about right.
Mia from Rainy City facing off against Kuyala. Again, an empty penalty box. We've got 5-on-5 on the track. Kuyala in the back, now being held very well by three brace of Rainy City, now guarding the back of the pack. We are at the top of the apex now, essentially three brace versus three brace, but it's going to be Kuyala taking lead.
So Kuyala has an 86% lead percentage, which is higher than anybody else that's like a regular jammer.
Yeah, I was going to say, Nina Irways, but it was like one jam out. But that's, you're like, you got to leave on a high note. Nina Irways was like, I'm good.
Yeah, and she's 100% for the lead jammer percentage in the second half.
Is that Kuyala?
Yeah.
Nice.
In the second half. So, a very effective jammer for Helsinki.
So Rainy City's Mia absolutely putting full weight onto Alu and one teammate, which is Salah. It's all that Carolinian up front, and now it's just Alu, finally released from this torture. She is through, and that's picking up 4 points for Rainy City. And Kiala ready to go ahead and call it off. That was an 8-point jam for Helsinki, an 8-point jam as well for Rainy City, bringing Rainy City to 132, Helsinki at 99.
Here in the replay, you can see Kiala trying to jump that apex, but Rainy City kind of closing the door and making sure that she doesn't get through to get those points. The WFTDA would like to thank Derby City Skates, Strong Athletic, and Chicks and Bowls. Jamie, now we have Ducky for Rainy City up against Mia. For Helsinki, Mia is lead. That's two in a row.
Yeah,
for Helsinki.
Blasting on through. Ducky, in the meantime, is out. A much faster pack than we're used to. Then does stop. Right as I say that, they're like, we're at the pivot line. We're good. So the pack is now, again, its own microcosmic swarm as Ducky hung up on Helsinki's back brace. Mia, similarly.
Oh, beautiful outside line there from Mia. Just... The floor is lava.
The floor is lava. It looks, I mean, unassuming, but I'm here to tell you. Mia now pressed into this very, very thick pack that's just kind of formed a tiny mob on turn one. Ducky getting knocked down, picking it back up as the pack is just continues to be... So thick, there's no way to get through it. So it's a lot of work for both of these jammers. Of course, Mia up front,
so
nearly
close.
Nearly had pressed through, does get knocked out to the outside. But having control of lead means you can just be like, I'm good.
I'm good.
Yeah, this is fine. I picked up 8 points. Let's be on my way.
Yeah. So it's 8-4, so that's 4 points on the differential.
Yeah.
Here in the replay. We see that. They're beautiful. I go here.
Yeah.
I fits. That's 136 to 107. We now have just under 7 minutes left in this half. In the game.
Yeah, I was like, this half is the game.
Yes. It's Malou jamming up against Fairy Quake.
Fairy Quake is going to take lead again for Rainy City as the pack resets itself right around the pivot line. Fairy Quake now entering on this first scoring pass. Thought she was going to be able to take the inside. It looks like, I believe that was Ligora, had different ideas about that inside, perhaps, that she was meant to be there. So didn't quite work out as Malou enters the pack, potentially picking up points. The jam is called. That was 3 points for Rainy City. Nothing, in fact, was picked up by Helsinki.
That's a beautiful shirt web you're seeing in the replay.
I enjoyed that shirt web quite a lot.
It's like, help me! Now that, like, jerseys have like some good stretch to them, you get some like really nice looking shirt whips.
Yeah.
We have Lauren Swafu jamming up against Kiala. Kiala so far with 100% lead percentage in the half, so we'll see if she's able to continue her streak.
Swafu. Again, trying to press through the three brace that Helsinki has placed at the back of the pack. And we, of course, see the same efforts coming from Kiala up front.
Everybody's in the bad place. I'm making a good place reference.
I was there. I wanted to follow up. I wanted to be with you on this. And it's too late. I can do like...
It's okay. Did you know that Kristen Bell is a vegetarian, so all the shrimp she's eating are fake?
I did not know that.
Yeah, there you go. There's your Saturday morning weird trivia from Tober.
I like it.
Yeah.
I need to know more about this shrimp, but not right now, I guess.
Okay, yeah,
I'm going to Google this. Or somebody on Twitter can get back to me and tell me what they're made of. I'm freaked out now.
Well, and somebody also just filed a patent on, like, fake shrimp. But anyway, we'll talk about fake shrimp more later.
Okay, okay.
At the front of the pack, we've got Kuyala stuck behind Yeatman. And Penny Black is out of the engagement zone, awarded lead.
That took nearly a minute and a half to do. And, you know, like we said at the beginning, we're like, if this first jam of the game is a testament to how the rest of this game is going to be. And it was for many of the jams.
It's
been, like, thick and just really tough packs to get past, interspersed with other jams. I mean, like, it's been very... the action has been varied. I've really very much enjoyed it. Kuyala does decide to call it off, and after picking up 2 points, it's
all that work for 2 points. I mean, they're important.
Those were
now
like
a 30-point game.
Those are the best 2 points, though, right?
Yeah, it's true.
So you can see just the absolute. I can't even think of a word to describe this.
Grueling.
I was like super hard effort.
Super hard. It is super hard.
It's really Mia. Good job. High fives for everyone. Mia from Helsinki facing off against Liz Yeatman. I believe this is Liz Yeatman's first time actually taking or starting off with the star. She did receive a star pass earlier in the game. So 0-0 jam as both the jammers came out, and there was not much interest in giving up points. Which is understandable. I mean, we're at a 30-point game right now. We've got under 3 minutes left in this game. And the winner from this game will play tonight at 8:30 against the winner of the next game, which is Angel City versus Bear City.
Can you imagine playing this game and then, like, getting not even a full nap in before you got to do it again?
I can't imagine going, like, 3 hours without getting a nap in, girl. So, like, maybe I'm not the one to ask.
Sorry.
No.
I didn't mean to offend you. So
oh, no, no. I'm just like.
And now we have a jammer penalty. That's Malu taking a seat in the penalty box. Going to be a power jam for Rainy City. Malu is sitting on a back block.
So Ducky is out there on the outside. You with the cameras have a better view than me with just my eyes on top of real time. But Ducky really having a hard time. Does try different avenues through the pack, but Helsinki is just reappearing everywhere she thinks to go. Finally, lead declared. Almost a full minute had elapsed there. So even as we get into these final jams, we see the strategy and energy and defense is still incredibly high.
Beautiful work there by Malu, able to get through, complete her initial pass. She's now scoring eligible. Great block all the, by Latnakainen to the outside, going to force the call off. And now we see a timeout being called. We only have a minute left in the period. Timeout being called by Helsinki. I see skating on the pack. Anyway, I just wanted to mention that Sarah Ekholm, one of the main blockers for Helsinki, has 6 penalties.
Oh well.
That's what I'm trying to say. I'm trying to get it out of my mouth, and now I've done. Just so you know.
I was just gonna shout out to Token Redshirt, who's been hugely fanning this game, but is pointed out that Rainy City defense really has to work overtime to neutralize Kuyala, and it is effective. And you're absolutely not wrong.
I mean, 89% lead percentage, a differential of 40, scoring 52 points out of 109. Like, if you're the Rainy City defense, you're just like, all of the energy goes to stopping that jammer.
It's like, just shout out to Liz Headrush, who says that Penny, a.k.a. No Goat Block, is not here for your ish.
Well.
And I'm like... word, because I will never in my life face these people. I'm kind of nervous about even imagining it. So
lead goes to Mia from Helsinki right off the bat.
A little bit of a rest up, because it's Fairy Quake is a pretty good lead percentage as well in this half.
Yeah, interesting fact for this half. Call up Helsinki can't stop the clock, but we have more than 30 seconds left, so we'll start again.
Yeah.
1 point for Helsinki. Just an interesting fact for this game so far. 15 penalties in the second half for Helsinki. Wow. Only six for Rainy City. So, you know.
It was a bit turned around from the first half, wasn't it? When yeah. Helsinki had no penalties.
For a while.
So, for so very long. Yeah, yeah.
And, you know, when you think about what is essentially a 32-point game, how many points were those 15 people sitting in the penalty box for 30 seconds? We have Kujala jamming up against Lauren Swaffield.
So as we get along the far straightaway, the pack is stretching out. Two final blockers now. One final blocker, Liz Yeatman, holding back Kujala, which is, you know, tough work. Kujala does make it out, and as the pack comes up to the far straightaway, she enters for her first scoring pass.
You know, don't forget the last time these two teams played was not that long ago. It was April, and the score was 184 for Rainy, 114 for Helsinki. So Helsinki is going to outperform that. They also, you know, had a great game yesterday, and they played yesterday. Rainy City didn't.
Yeah, it's true.
I want to take a second to say thank you to Texas Roller Girls and Derby Girl Designs.
As you can see, the front of the pack, like the period clock is done, and we've got 43 seconds left on the jam clock. That's going to go the full 43 seconds. Oh no, sorry, Kujala had lead. My bad.
Yes.
There has been a jammer penalty called on Banshee, and Kujala coming through still has control of this and still has the ability to pick up, you know, as many points as possible in the last 20 seconds. So. She gonna do it.
That's another one.
How are you feeling, Tober, about as we get to these last couple of seconds?
I love a good run at the end of a jam. Like even if, and I don't know, I've never seen a 32-point jam without jammer lap points. I'm not gonna say it's not impossible. I've never seen it, but a good run at the end of a jam. There it is. Brought it down to 20 points, 142 to 126 in the unofficial final. I'd feel really good if I were Helsinki. I mean, they weren't able to hold on to that lead all the way through the second half, but 20 points with this kind of ranking differential is nothing to laugh at. I mean, it's six, right? Because Helsinki is ranked 16th, mm-hmm. and Rainy City is ranked 10th. I know that doesn't seem, when you're talking about 400 teams, it doesn't seem like a lot, but when you get up to the top, every single ranking is a lot.
It really is.
This is a great showing for Helsinki, a great turn. Like, I'd feel really good if I were them.
No, definitely. No, like keeping up such momentum and such amazing strategy and having, you know, a very tight and much smaller than you would imagine jammer rotation. There's so many great things to be said about Helsinki's gameplay today and other times in their career. So, like, yeah, it was absolutely admirable efforts on behalf of both teams. The score is now final. Rainy City taking it with 145. Helsinki taking it with 100, or sorry, opposed to Helsinki's 126.
Yeah. And Rainy City, let's not undersell that. They went into that locker room. They made the adjustments they needed to make.
Absolutely.
They shut down the jammers they weren't able to shut down. They didn't let Helsinki get in their head because, you know, when you come in ranked higher than someone, sometimes you're like, we're going to be ahead the whole game.
Right. And yeah, they're not resting on their laurels, essentially. And so that's, you know.
And they didn't get, like, sad or that you didn't see the bench fall apart. They just doubled down, locked it up.
Now, the spirits have been really amazing amongst all of the teams this weekend. And we see the upcoming team, Beer City, dancing on the sidelines. Angel City also waiting for free high fives because one of the many benefits of joining us in person is that they will just give you high fives.
It's awesome.
Yeah, it's amazing. Where I come from, you paid quite a pretty penny for the not from the best place. But, yeah, so next up, as you may have guessed from that, is Angel City versus Bear. So to say what has occurred from this, Rainy City will be taking on either Angel City or Bear City tonight at 8:30 p.m. Eastern, which for Rainy City would be a five-hour difference
So that's like 1:30 in the morning. So if Manchester, you're up, you're super dedicated. Helsinki will play tomorrow at 11 a.m. and will face off against Paris Roller Girls. So that's where we are right now with the bracket. If you're interested in, again, following the statistics or getting their brackets, you can check out the brackets on Facebook. Wftda has been doing quite a lot on social media, so you can follow along. You can check out statistics on stats.wftda.com. And I just hope you're enjoying this weekend as much as we are.
I know, we really are. I just want to take a moment and say thank you to Rydell, Radar Wheels, Powerdyne, and RollerCon.
And thank you all for tuning in, either to look or just to listen. And hopefully we'll see you later today.
Okay, we're going to go down to the sideline for an interview. So stay tuned for that coming up right now.
All right. Hi, it's Electra Blue here, and I'm here with Fairy Quake, who's a bit nervous. It's her first interview, so I told her she's going to be fine. So be nice out there. So first of all, Helsinki, we talked to yesterday. They were super hungry for this game. I know you all have played each other a lot. They've only beaten you one time, and it was a couple of years ago. But first half, they were looking strong. What adjustments did you make for the second half?
Well, knowing that we could definitely beat them. Right, we've had that experience. We know the team really well and love Helsinki so much. Like, it's a shame that we have to knock them out to get into champs. But, yeah, just knowing that we can switch it up.
Well, I mean, that's why we're here, right, is to get to champs. That's the next road. So the next game is going to be, you're going to be watching that one because you'll be playing tonight at 8:30, the winner of that. So that's Angel City and Bear City. Now, Angel City, you played last year at playoffs. You're hoping to have a rematch of that game?
No. We're hoping to beat them this year. It was so close. I remember going on that final jam and thinking, we can definitely do this, but we were like 30 points down. It was a realistic dream. But we're not going to get in that situation this year. We're going to dominate.
Excellent. Well, and of course, we still have to see who the winner is, too. Now, you had a great second half yourself, that 20-point jam. That's kind of really sort of sealed the deal because you were always within a 20-point spread. So what do you personally do to work out to get yourself to this physical level?
We train all the time, working out with my buddies, like off skates. And like we really pump each other up on the bench, like jammers, we have a little club and just tell each other how great we are, and like doing it at training and at games, it really makes us believe that we can do it.
So at the end there, I saw your coach was really riling you up with the chant. What's the chant that you all do out there?
We have skate smart, hit hard, play together, and then we just say together a lot of times.
You want to send us out to your fans?
Yeah, sure.
All right, let's do it.
Skate, smart, hit hard, play together.
All right. That's what they're going to do. So keep watching Rainy City. They're going to be playing at 8:30 tonight.